This is Jason Reed Pratt, author of Cry of Justice. Have you ever wanted to train police and military divisions in South Vietnamese cities, except less than you legally could, because you're trying to be nice to the communist hordes intent on terrorizing the population you're willing to govern nicely for a while until they go away? The communists, I mean? Me too! Fortunately, I'm playing the Army of the Republic of Vietnam in a multiplayer team game of Fire in the Lake, designed by Volky Runke and Mark Herman. We're continuing turn two, after I've already done the aforementioned, and now my teammate, Bart Hart, who is briefly taking a break from crushing me at strategy games to crush my foes before me, has gotten the option, thanks to my choice last turn, of playing this turn's card event or else playing one of his normal operations with only one target, and with no special mission. Bart, agreeing with my recommendation, chooses to play the clean vote flavor of election. This gives me, the Arvin player, another plus 10 in aid, which, remember, isn't cash I can use yet, but which I'll be able to use later. Bart, even as my United States ally, could have chosen the shaded flavor of election to mess me up, since in a normal competitive version of this game only one player can win. But we're playing a full team version for the sake of the new players, where the team wins or loses together. The card event also allows him to upgrade passive opposition in the three areas that will most affect his score. Binh Dinh, Saigon, and Kien Hoa. This adds their population numbers to his score again for a total of 10 extra points. This puts him well past his winning goal, but since this is a full team game, we have to get me past my goalpost too, which happens to be the same 51 points or more, and I'm still way back here at 35 points. But Bart, and or I, can now carefully sacrifice some of his points to help my score through patronage. Turn 3. The Masher White Wing event becomes current, with the VC and then the NVA having initiative this turn. The upcoming card, however, is... Eek! Long-range guns! If the NVA passes this turn, they'll get first crack at this permanent capability event, which, despite the event name, will give them more ammunition for their shots, not more range. Team North has some hard choices to make between exploiting early opportunities for destruction or patiently gathering their minions for later. VC Larry takes the Masher White Wing card event, which will allow him to kick quite a lot of butt with his specs and then allow his NVA partner to play a full operation with special action. Historically, this event represents the United States 1st Air Cavalry teaming up with Arvin and South Korean units to hunt and destroy NVA divisions in Binh Dinh Province in 1966. Supposedly, but mistakenly, with total success. This was not, by the way, part of Operation Silver Bayonet 1 earlier in 65, where American forces led by Hal Moore and the 1st Air Cavalry fought NVA regulars for the first time at Ia Drong Valley, but the two operations did overlap somewhat. In the game, this event allows one Team North player, either VC or the NVA, but not both, to play three limited march operations, where each march op has one target, using their guerrillas, the little round special operation chips, or specs as I like to call them, and then also grants a free ambush special mission in each marched target area. Usually, ambushes require at least one hidden spec to activate in order to kick off the mission, but in this case, the Team North specs can be already active with the little star showing. Or they can even safely activate while marching into an area which already has too much Team South security and or Team North presence. First march, one spec from Plai Khu to Phu Bon. I have to note that this moves into a road space, then off a road space into a province space, when the march rule does not allow Team North units to pass off the roads, known in this game as lines of communication, or LOCs. VC Larry later explains that he has played Team South a little too much, where their greater mobility allows them to include roads in their moves, not limit their moves to roads. Team North doesn't have that mobility, but I don't insist he take back this move this time. We're at the start of the game and no one is playing factions that we're familiar with yet. Free ambush, per card event, knocks Arvin's only cube here, a police division, to available. This ambush would still be valid even if the spec could get no further than the road, by the way. And his spec would have shut down my road, too. Notice that I myself misunderstood the combat rule for Arvin losses to send pieces completely out of play for a while, including for this turn. So while I should have sent them to available, I'm going to send these cubes out of play. But I wanted to explain the real rule while I was going by. Second March. One spec, already active, from Quang Duc to Can Hoa. Even though a road space does exist between those two spaces, this would still be allowed due to the towns connecting the two provinces, either one of which the piece could have passed through with no extra marching. A free ambush per card event, and Larry again knocks out the only Arvin cube here, a police division. Third March, a hidden VC spec from Kien Phong to Kien Hoa. This crosses a line of communication, the only loc on the board that combines a river and a road, with no town joint between the provinces. There are large cities on either side of the loc, yes, but those can't be moved through without marching. Again, I'm being nice on the first turns, I let it slide this time. Once again, the ambush knocks my only cube, once again a police division, off the board, which should have been to my available box, but which I sent out of play instead due to my own misunderstanding of Arvin and casualty rules at the time. And this activates the spec. Again, remember that the ambush would still have been valid even if the spec could get no farther than the road, because ambushes can hit from an adjacent space. Arvin's score reduces by 4 population points from 35 to 31, as I lose coin control in each of those provinces. NVA Dave has second initiative this turn, and thanks to VC Larry playing the event, Dave would have the option for a full operation plus special mission. But Dave decides he wants the permanent capability event from the next card more, and so passes this turn, getting 1 resources, with red cash going up to 12. That ends the turn. Turn 4. We discard the Masher White Wing event. We move long guns to current. And we draw our first coup upcoming, Brash Brass Kai. The Long Guns card says that NVA Dave gets first initiative this turn and plays the event, gaining the Long Range Guns capability permanently. Now he only needs some cubes to use it! The United States passes, since with the coup coming up, his military options are limited and he doesn't have many forces on the board yet, nor in good places to strike yet, and I can give myself troops and aid better than he can give them to me anyway. By passing, he collects 3 Arvin cash for me. Arvin cash goes up to 21. I get to play a full op and special activity again. I pretty much have to train and govern again as my best option. My first train target is Danang City. 1 troop, 1 police, minus 3 cash, down to 18. My current regime leader, who's about to be replaced next turn, should have given me plus 5 aid up to 44 for training even one area, but I forgot in all the excitement, and I don't think I ever correct that later. Train Kwinan City, 1 troop, 1 police, minus 3 cash to 15. And I train in Kamran City, 1 troop, 1 police, minus 3 cash, down to 12. I'm still limiting myself to 6 cubes total spread anywhere during a train operation, not 6 cubes per target. Training allows me to pacify 2 levels in a train target with police and troops and control. So I choose Danang, from neutral to active support. Arvin cash down from 12 to 6. US score goes up from 55 to 57. Govern will be my special mission again, and I can select 2 areas where I have support but won't be training this turn. This time I select the city of Wei, due to its 2 population, which for good governments gives me 3 times 2 pop equals 6 added to my aid. My other target is An Lok again, although that could be Kanto City instead, it doesn't matter, for 3 times 1 pop equals 3 more aid. The upcoming first coup card will take a while for us to process, so instead of smushing all that here into episode 2, I'll dedicate next episode to that, when it will be... now, Kai's turn? For Doom?
Doom, 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 Doom. Amen, 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 amen dun 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 d